because he sat on his daddy's shoulders and he could see that it wasn't about him, it was about everybody else and in the future. It was about me and you, literally. He saw that he would win and that he would win for us all. Literally what happens is that we are now prepared to enter into our blessings. Why? Because you and I don't know how to appreciate blessings if it hasn't cost us anything. Oh, let me just say this to you. How many of you remember you wanted the best of your shoes? You wanted the best kind of tennis shoes. And you would tell your mom and dad, I want these kind of shoes. But those shoes cost $100+. I remember the first Jordans when they came out. They were the very first tennis shoe that was over $100. Oh, I want those shoes. Daddy said, you're crazy. Your brother's huge shoes will fit you. They're good enough. I find out there were Olgas. They've been passed down. By the time I got them, they're lower than me. But when somebody buys you something new, you don't really take care of it, do you? It didn't cost you anything. You know, you buy your kids shoes and they're out of the mud. You know, it didn't cost. But things change when it's your money. You have money, why don't you buy it? Or if you do buy it, you what? Take care of it. Can I borrow it? I ain't gonna let you borrow it. I don't think so. Why? It cost you something. It cost you something. And any information that costs you, you're gonna appreciate it. Do you know what my professor in college told me about pastoral counseling? He says, you need to charge your people when they come to ask for advice. I said, what? That's not what churches. He goes, no, you need to, because then they'll learn to appreciate what you have to share. I thought, wow, that's pretty good. So starting Monday. But it made perfect sense, right? It makes perfect sense, because if it costs you something, you're going to appreciate it. Going through the desert teaches you to appreciate what you didn't have or what you already have. And what happens is, when you appreciate it, then you take everything that you learned and you gather it in information, and now you're ready to get the blessing. Now, because why? You understand it's not about you. The blessing isn't for you. It's about everybody else around you. Now I'm not selfish anymore. It's not about promoting myself. It's about I have this blessing to share with people around me. Praise His holy name. Because there may be a missionary coming to our church that literally God has blessed you. Before, you would have been selfish and said, I'll only give him $10. But now, because you're ready, because you gathered all that information, God has said, you give him $100. And without any hesitation, you do it because you've been prepared. Or let's take it a little bit further. In my own household, you see, I understand that what has been given to me is my blessing. Now that I've been through the desert, I learned that these are literally blessings to me, not a burden. So now my whole perspective changes. The way I talk and communicate to my spouse, or the way I communicate and talk to my children, or when I go to work, the way I communicate and talk to my coworkers, or even how I even do my work. It becomes more diligent, and it becomes more appropriate. It becomes, this is serious business here. I don't need to be a slacker, because my work has an effect on my boss. It may even be to a point that their job is dependent on what you do at work. But it doesn't bother us, because we're not the boss. Until we become the boss, then guess what? We're worried about everybody's performance. We weren't worried about it when we were there. So you see, you understand that once I've been in the desert, I understand how to appreciate what I don't have or what I do have. Now I'm prepared for my blessing. And God won't hold back when He blesses. The only reason why He does is because we tell Him. We literally tie His hands. We tie His hands. We'll say things to Him like, God, I'm not really ready for this journey yet. Folks, you're missing out on your blessing. us. I'm not ready to commit to God totally. You're missing out on your blessings. I'm not ready because, you see, I'll give up this and I'll give up that, and I'm not ready to give up that. But, boy, you don't realize you've already given up all this. And I'll tell you, all of this affects your children, because God says He doesn't just bless you. He blesses from one generation to the next, to the next, to the next, to the next. And along the line, there'll be somebody in your family lineage that says, I praise God for my great-great-great-great-great-great-great-grandpa that stood up, or great-great-great-great-great-grandmother, whatever, great-great-great-aunt, who was the only one who was willing to stand up in the middle of anything else and be able to hold up the standard. And because of that, I have been blessed. And let me tell you, you might have been complaining that you're in the desert, but I hope today you have a different perspective. That you learn to embrace the things that God has brought you and lead you into, so that you would learn to appreciate the values of the things that you don't have and are about to get, and the things that you don't have at all or do have. Bow your heads with me, please.